Hey everyone, Tech Steve here, and today I have Matt Barber with Hisense, and he's going to tell you guys a little bit about the new 2022 model televisions coming out with the ones behind us. So can you tell me a little bit about these new models, Matt?
Absolutely, Steve, and thank you for having me here. So this year, we're very excited to bring out our 2022 ULED models into the U.S. 2021 for Hisense and our ULED models was a huge success. So it was one of our most award-winning years. Our expert reviews and consumer reviews were just off the charts. One of the best years in terms of that we've ever had. Very excited to kind of build off of that. And the way that we're doing it this year is, if you look right here, we've got our 65U6 model. What we're doing with it is we're adding things like far field voice control to it. So you don't even need the remote anymore. You talk to the television.
Tech Steve, please say a command.
It'll interact with all of your smart home enabled devices, such as, you know, Google, Alexa, without the use of the remote itself. So that's a really cool feature for it, as well as we are introducing VRR at 60 hertz for this television for the first time this year. So for the gamers and for those smart home fanatics, adding some more of those features to the U6. When we get to the U7, the big sort of upgrade for it is we're building an 85-inch
version. 85-inch?
Absolutely. Okay. So it's now going to come from a 55 all the way up to an 85-inch version. That television last year we kind of positioned as a great for gaming TV.
Right.
Because it had all the bells and whistles in terms of VRR at 120. It's got FreeSync Premium Pro in it. And it had the size availability that a lot of people are looking for a big gaming experience, and those technologies needed for Xbox One, PS5, and so forth for the next generation console. So being able to bring an extra size to that category is huge for us. When we get into the U8, the biggest transition we have here is that we are now moving into mini LED technology.
So LED with Hisense.
Absolutely.
Are you kidding me?
Not at all.
Okay.
And obviously very excited about it. It's gonna be not only in the U8, but we're bringing it into the U9 as well.
Well, let me ask you something. In 2021, your company was aggressive. I have never seen a TV company really come to life like that. Do you know any of the motivation behind all these commercials I'm seeing, these fantastic videos all over line? I mean, what's really going on with Hisense?
When it comes to brand marketing, you've really got to give credit to that team. Being able to come up with all of the ideas and be able to execute those ideas the way that they have. As you've seen with Dwayne Wade and you've seen with Joel McHale, you're going to see even more of that kind of stuff come from Hisense in 2022. Very excited to see that sort of keeping it real. That is the mantra that we're having
right now.
Is making sure that technology is understood as to why the consumer would even want some of this stuff in terms of QLED and ULED and mini LED. Why do you want these things? It's very important to us to make sure that we make that message clear to the consumers so that they know what they're buying, and they know what they're buying is something that they actually need. We're going to do that in a very fun way. We're going to do that in a very almost tongue-in-cheek way sometimes, because technology is supposed to be fun. It's not supposed to be cold and hard and just, you know, just shoving jargon down your throat. That's not what it's about.
Yes.
It's about having fun, but understanding that what you're buying is not only quality, but it's going to fit your lifestyle.
Now, Matt, you told me you guys have some 8K television on the other side?
Yes, sir.
Do you mind if we go take a look at those 8Ks?
Absolutely, we can definitely do that.
Okay, yeah, let's go take a look at the 8K and I'd like to learn a little bit more about that TV
as
well. All right, guys, Matt and I have moved over to the U800 8K television. And you know, 8K is kind of one of those things that we're still trying to get 4K, right?
Absolutely.
So why would someone even consider 8K, considering that there's so many 4Ks on the market and not a lot of signal?
Well, and that's the problem that we ran into earlier when 4K first came out. There wasn't a lot of content. We're seeing that same thing here with the 8K. You're absolutely right. What I can say is this. Though there may not be a lot of 8K content out there, our television comes with an 8K upscaler. So we'll take 4K content or even 1080p content and boost it to near 8K quality. So you are going to get a benefit out of having an 8K television when it comes to the resolution of the content that you already know about and own.
Okay.
So that shouldn't be too much of an issue there.
Okay, so looking at this U800, let's talk more practical, okay?
Okay.
Let's talk about, does it have any local dimming zones?
It absolutely has local dimming zones. The count off the top of my head, I don't know, to be quite honest.
No problem.
I apologize to everyone for that. But it is 4K, excuse me, it is 8K, it is quantum dot, it is a 120 hertz native panel. You do have variable refresh rate at 120. It is a Roku TV, so for those people that are familiar with the Roku platform, they'll
yes.
be very familiar with how to get this TV up and running very easily.
Yeah, I actually like Roku. People always ask me, oh, there's Tizen out there from Samsung, mm-hmm. there's, you know, the LG WebOS.
Right.
But Roku, you know, it's been around for a long time.
Absolutely.
They're well known. Mm-hmm. But the real thing I really like about Roku is they're fast. I mean, you turn it on and it clicks through it. So have you seen any kind of lag or anything on this television compared to?
No, and to your point, you know, Roku is a very stable system. Not only that, they're constantly doing updates on
it. Yes,
they are. They're constantly adding free TV to the Roku channel app. So mm-hmm. you get a ton of options with the Roku TV platform and OS, and very excited to bring an 8K version of our televisions with that Roku OS platform to the US market.
Wow, I think that's gonna be great. And just looking at it, is this a 4K signal right here?
It is a 4K signal that we're upscaling.
Wow, it's nice. And one thing I liked about this TV as well is these feet right here.
Yeah.
It looks like new space age kind of stuff. Because a lot of people are putting these square feet on their TVs.
Absolutely.
And do you know anything about the design behind that or anything?
So we're always kind of tweaking and playing around with TV ID. And one of the things that you'll see with all of our televisions is a lot of different types of stands that we use.
Yes.
What you'll see in some of our more premium models, especially with something like this,
right?
is we like this butterfly design because of the aesthetic. It
yes.
just shows off a little bit more of a premium professional feel to it.
Absolutely.
And we've gotten a lot of positive feedback, not only on this model, but some of the other high-end models that have that butterfly stand as the base.
Yeah, I remember years ago you guys used to have this feature where you could move the feet, because
yeah.
you know, like you have a small stand
mm-hmm.
and everybody's putting these feet on wide, it would give you the option to integrate.
Absolutely.
So I'm looking around here. I think you guys have some laser projector or anything like that?
Ultra short throw laser projection, absolutely. We
okay.
can show you that too.
Yeah, let's go take a look at that. And so I'm pretty sure you guys want to check it out. All right, guys, now we're over here at the laser projecting television. And one thing that really stood out to me is that it has 3,000 lumens.
Absolutely, 3,000 lumens. So HDR content is going to look absolutely fantastic on this laser projector.
And it looks like it's in front of it. So
yep.
What's the concept behind having a laser projector?
Absolutely. So the laser projection technology, the only way that you can get ultra short throw is with lasers. And with the L9G trichroma, you are about a foot and a half away, maybe a little bit less, from the actual screen. By closing that distance of throw,
uh-huh.
you maintain brightness, you maintain color saturation, you maintain the crisp clarity of 4K that you are expecting out of a 4K projection television.
Wow, and what type of inputs do this have? Because I know people on my channel sometimes they buy lasers, projectors, or some type of projectors, not like this, and they always saying that it only has inputs, so they can't use HDMI sound bars or anything like that. What does this have to offer?
This is a fully functioning television. It's smart. It runs on the Android TV operating system.
Okay.
It has multiple HDMI inputs. It's got fiber optic out, ER
wow.
connections. You've got basically everything that your TV at home has, this TV is capable of using. So if you were to disconnect the TV you have at home, put this in its place, you could connect everything right back in.
So I'm gonna show you guys a little bit close up of what this laser projector has to offer so you guys can kind of understand how it works. So one thing I noticed is right here, it has like this little box right here. What is that little slot for?
So that's the window to where the throw is coming out of the television itself. So as you can see here, the picture is actually coming through that lens.
And it has, one, two, or three different color light bulbs or something?
There are no light bulbs in our laser television, none whatsoever. So there's no light bulb replacement that you have to do 2 and 3 years out. We have three dedicated lasers to red, green, and blue to give you the purest color you can possibly get out of a display technology.
So is there anything else that you need to know by buying a laser? And who's it for, actually? Because I never thought about one myself.
Right. I mean, it's not a typical solution for most people, but it is the solution for someone that's looking for a cinematic experience
mm-hmm.
for all of your content, your gaming, your sports, your movies, regular television. This is a way of having that movie theater experience with all of those pieces.
Well, Matt, I really appreciate you showing us all your televisions, the 8K, the laser, Hisense. They're looking up this year.
Thank you. It's my pleasure.